Hi there, it's AJ here, and if you're watching this video, you're quite possibly either using the 2019 WordPress theme or you're considering giving it a try. The one thing you can say about this theme is that while it is really very good, you don't want to have exactly the same look and feel as everybody else who's using it. And the theme developers have not made it easy for us to make changes and modifications. Even something as simple as changing the logo to a rectangular one is not easy. So what I've done is I've created all the classes that you need in CSS, and you can just copy and paste those into the CSS area of your customizer, and we can take it from there. So let's dive in and start off by looking at how the default template looks compared to how it looks once we apply the new styling. Here's the template with the homepage on my demo site. The first thing I wanted to change was the logo, as I'd mentioned. I don't like being forced to use a circular one. This clunky navigation has to go, it just offends me. And also I've done something with the social icons. So if we look at the homepage with the new styling applied, the first thing you'll notice is that I have a clearly defined header area. I've got a rectangular navigation here. I've reworked the icons for the social. All this is totally adjustable, of course. And I had to do something with the navigation. I couldn't stand that big ugly font. And looking down the page a little bit, I've centered the text and put a border around that you can remove or change as you wish. Now if we turn our attention to the blog page, here's how it looks by default. And apart from the styling changes I've already mentioned, the one thing that I really didn't like was the size of the featured image. It's okay on one post perhaps, but once you look at the second post and then the third post and the fourth post, it gets a bit much. So here's what I've done. I have restricted the size of the feature image to, I think it's 250 pixels, and I've used the CSS property called Object Fit. That allows the image to be resized and then automatically cropped from the center. So as long as the focus of your image was roughly around the middle somewhere, then you should get a reasonable crop that you'd be happy with. While I'm on this page, it's worth noting that if you look at the continue reading link, the excerpt doesn't actually work in this theme. We'll go and take a quick look at that. So if I go to edit post and we go into the document section here, let's just scroll down a bit. There's the box here for writing an optional excerpt. Well, you may as well just delete that because it doesn't work. I'm not sure why, whether it hasn't been enabled on this theme or there's some bug, but the way to get around that is to use the read more block in the Gutenburg block builder. So just write your excerpt at the top, the first few lines of your post, and then add a new block below it, and the one you're looking for is called more. If you don't see it here in the most used ones, just look under the layout elements and you'll find it in there. So I thought it was worth mentioning that because if that caught me out, I'm sure it's caught other people out as well. Now let's turn our attention to the blog page. Sorry, the blog posts, individual posts. And I'm sure you can tell what I'm going to complain about here, and that is the full screen image here. This is the feature image. Now I don't like it that big. I'd rather have something smaller, so here's what I've done. I have restricted the height of this and I've set it to 60% of the height of the screen. Now that is going to apply to whether you're on a desktop or a mobile or a tablet. In fact, I'll just show you here. If I have a reduced browser that's roughly approximating the width of a mobile, you can see that it's still taking up 60%. And if I just resize that, you can see how the image works. It just shrinks down as much as it can, keeping the same aspect ratio. You'll also notice that on the blog pages that have a featured image like this, the navigation bar and the whole header is just a standard scrolling one. The reason for that is that this background feature image is actually placed in the header. So if we had a fixed navigation, then there wouldn't be much room to scroll. Wouldn't be a good user experience. Same thing applies on a page that's got a featured image set. So if I go to test page here, that is a standard page, it's not a post, but I have set a featured image. I'm not sure what penguins have got to do with little pugs, but you can see that the navigation does actually scroll on this. So let's just turn our attention to the CSS that I've given in the download. I'll go to the Customise area of my dashboard and we'll just take a bit of a look at that. So if you download the text file that's got all of the CSS here, the whole thing, and just paste it into this area, what I've done is I've organized it into areas so that it works from the top downwards. So we start with the body and then the logo, the top nav, the header, down to the headlines and so on. And each area is well commentated so that you can change colors, paddings, margins and what have you. So I think that pretty well wraps it up. You can either go with the plain boring default look and feel, or you can change that to something that looks a little bit more modern, well, to my eyes at least, and you could take it from there. I hope it's been helpful to you, and if you've enjoyed the video and you'd like to see more of these, just give me a like and maybe think about subscribing, and we'll catch up with you next time. Thanks for watching.